Hello and welcome. I am Dr. Martin, a neuroradiologist and professor of head and neck radiology. In this video, we will analyze two interesting radiology cases that share the same diagnosis and demonstrate typical imaging features on MRI. Let's begin with the first case. This is a 39-year-old woman with left-sided sensory neural hearing loss. She underwent an MRI of the internal auditory canals with contrast to evaluate the underlying cause. We will now review the MRI findings. On the non-contrast axial T1 weighted sequence, we see a well-defined lobulated lesion located in the left cerebellopontine angle. The lesion appears hypointense on T1. On the high-resolution axial T2 weighted sequence, the lesion shows heterogeneous signal intensity with hyperintense areas suggesting cystic degeneration or necrosis. On the coronal T2 weighted sequence, we can clearly see mass effect on the brainstem, specifically on the middle cerebellar peduncle and the left cerebellar hemisphere. After contrast administration, the axial T1 post-contrast images show intense enhancement with focal non-enhancing areas, which correspond to cystic or necrotic components. Overall, these findings are consistent with a left vestibular schwannoma involving the cerebellopontine angle and the internal auditory canal, with evidence of cystic degeneration and mass effect on adjacent brain structures. Let's move on to the second case. This is a 50-year-old man with right-sided sensory neural hearing loss. He also underwent an MRI of the internal auditory canals with contrast. In this case, we only have post-contrast images. On both the axial and coronal T1 weighted sequences with contrast, we see a well-defined enhancing lesion in the right internal auditory canal. Unlike the previous case, there are no signs of cystic degeneration or necrosis. This lesion is also consistent with a vestibular schwannoma confined to the right internal auditory canal and presenting as a solid enhancing mass. Now let's review some key points about vestibular schwannomas. Vestibular schwannoma, also known as acoustic neuroma, is a benign tumor that arises from the vestibular portion of the 8th cranial nerve. It originates at the transition zone between Schwann cells and glial cells, known as the Obersteiner-Redlich zone. On MRI, these tumors typically appear hypointense on T1, hypointense on T2, and show strong enhancement after contrast administration. Small tumors located entirely within the internal auditory canal are known as intracanalicular schwannomas. When larger, they may extend into the cerebellopontine angle, forming a classic ice cream cone appearance on axial images. Larger lesions can present with cystic degeneration, necrosis, or even intratumoral hemorrhage. These changes can affect the pattern of enhancement and may impact the response to treatment, especially in cases managed with radiosurgery. When reporting these cases, it is important to measure the distance between the lateral margin of the tumor and the fundus of the internal auditory canal. This measurement, although not the only one, plays a critical role in surgical planning. Clinically, vestibular schwannomas most commonly present with progressive sensory neural hearing loss. However, small tumors can be asymptomatic and incidentally discovered on brain imaging studies. The presence of bilateral vestibular schwannomas is highly suggestive of neurofibromatosis type 2 and should prompt further evaluation. The differential diagnosis includes other cerebellopontine angle and internal auditory canal masses such as meningioma, epidermoid cyst, aneurysm, facial nerve schwannoma, metastasis, and arachnoid cyst. Before we end this video, I invite you to watch another interesting case on this channel about the radiologic appearance of jugular bulb variants. You'll find the link in the comments section below. If you found this video useful, please consider subscribing to the channel, giving it a thumbs up, and sharing it with colleagues who may benefit from head and neck imaging content. I would also love to read your thoughts and questions in the comments. Thank you very much for your time. I hope this video on the MRI findings of vestibular schwannoma was helpful. See you in the next video on Dr. Martin, Head and Neck Radiology.